Now, a ring counter. A ring counter is a circular shift register with only one flip-flop being set at any particular time. All other are cleared, the single bit shifted from one flip-flop to other flip-flop. You can just see this particular construction clearly. Here, four D flip-flops are there, okay? And we are applying the common clock pulse to all the flip-flops. Now, there are two parts. This is what? Set part and the reset part, okay? So, this is what? Clock pulse. And this is D input and Q output. Here it is Q dash. So when set is equal to 1, so now output will be 1. Okay, and if R is equal to 1, then output will be 0. So to reset the circuit or to set the circuit externally, we can use these two points S and R. Okay. Now if E is equal to 1, now if E is equal to 1 means what? Now set is equal to, now it is set and remaining are reset. Means the output will be what? Output will be this one, 1001. So because E is connected with this particular set, it is 1, but here it is reset, reset, reset means 000. Now if you apply, now disable this one, disable this particular. Now if you apply the clock pulses, okay, if you apply the clock pulses, then this one will shift here, okay, this 0 will shift here, this 0 will shift here. Now you can see here Q4, this one is connected with to the input of the first. So this 0 will transfer from this position to that means. Now Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, initialization is what? 1000. Okay, that means 1000. Now if you apply clock pulse, say apply second clock pulse, so apply first clock pulse, then it will shift the data. So 1 will shift here, so 1 will shift there, this 0 will shift here, this 0 will shift here, and this 0, Q4 0, this 0 is connected with the input of the first. So this 0 will shift here, this 0 will shift here, okay. So this 0 shifter means we can draw here, this will 0 will shift here. So this 1 will shift here, this will be 1, 0, 0, this will be 0. And if you apply second clock pulse, then what will happen? This 1 will shift here, this 0 will shift here, now this 0 will shift here, okay, and this 0 will shift here. If you apply fourth clock pulse, okay, so first clock pulse, second clock pulse, third clock pulse, if you apply this is first clock pulse, this is initialization, first clock pulse, second clock pulse, third clock pulse, this 1 will come here, this 0 will come here, this 0 will come, this 0 will come here, clear? And after and fourth clock pulse, this 1 will shift here, this 0 will shift here, this 0 will shift here, this 0 will shift here. We use ring counter for frequency prescaler, for cryptanalysis, for decimal arithmetic in computer, to count the data in the continuous loop, used in frequency divided circuits and so on. And properties, simply, first of all, it is a synchronous counter. Okay, it's a synchronous counter because common clock pulse to all flip-flop. Number of states is equal to the number of flip-flop used. Okay, so how many stages are there? Four flip-flops are there. How many stages are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Four stages are there because this one is this particular state. Because this particular stage is a repetition of this particular stage. Okay, so how many? So total four distinct stages are there. Now the repetition will start. Okay, so number of states is equal to the number of flip-flops used. And finally, total number of unused state is 2^n-1, because 4 flip flops are there. How many total states are there? So 2^4, and total you existing number of states what? 4. So total unused what? 3 minus 4, that is 12 unused states are there. So this is what ring counter.